guys. We got this.
The Diana was the queen of hearts. Mother Teresa was the queen of the poor.
I think she was a weapon of propaganda.
But I am living life because of...
Watch it. Oh, here we go.
Sponsored by Bet365.
The race for Champions League football next season is well and truly alive. Spurs have beaten Leicester by 3-1. 2 goals for Son in the second. Harry Kane opened the scoring for Spurs.
I think
in action with a consolation for Leicester. Spurs are now into fourth. 1 point ahead of Arsenal.
Not long.
This game in hand against West Ham United. Only a victory will see them back into the top four at their rivals' expense. It's all to play for here at the London Stadium.
Oh, Brian couldn't get on the break already. Is that why he can't get a start? I'm back in.
When Bet365 was created, we had a simple vision. We wanted to connect people to every game.
I just want to win 3-0, 18-1. I don't know if I mean. I don't even know. Apparently we're supposed to be playing West Ham 17, but I don't know. It's so good. Thanks in the lineup. Oh, I've shared before the next shot.
See you later,
Rob.
Blue.
I'm getting.
Absolutely not. It's blue.
Run what you take. Hybrid and electric range.
That's so funny, that. Thierry Henry looking on smiling. The king.
Rediscovering their form at just the right time under Mikel Arteta. Three without a win, and then victories over Chelsea and Manchester United. And now they head to West Ham United for our second game of this Super Sunday. They're cranking up the PA here. The question is, how much will West Ham have in the tank? How much will West Ham fans have in the tank after Thursday night, Jamie?
Yeah, it was an emotional night for them. But they'd always give something here, knowing the season's coming to an end. From Arsenal's point of view, you've got to capitalise on that. Maybe those dials are a little bit tight. There's a load of injuries at the back. But watch their last game, Arsenal, when they played against Chelsea. They were fearless. They were fantastic. And Nketiah was amazing in that game. And Saka, he's changed it. He's brought in Martinelli. They've got plenty of pace on the back against the West Ham side that are decimated with injuries.
You love that anthem, Jermaine, don't you? What impact will the changes have on West Ham United today, do you think?
West Ham's 52nd game of the season. Arsenal's 45.
To get back in the team, basically. You know, these players, especially Mark Noble being back in the team, you know, and like we said before, Declan Rice playing today. Two leaders, so yeah, we'll
see. The set of bums in there, and you call that second team. Been rock, what a load of shit. Rubbish.
Spurs have got the job done. Can Arsenal get the job done, Graham?
Yeah. Listen, West Ham have had a fabulous season. They have to be at it today. They know they've got an Arsenal team coming here with their tails up. What West Ham can have is get bashed up today. We build up to Thursday. Instead of get beat on Thursday and the season will fizzle out and people think it's been a disappointing season. Up to this very point, West Ham have been fabulous. They've got to dig out a result today if they can. Don't get bashed up and somehow dig out a result. Not a good season, not a very good season for me. That'd be a great season. Today's important to them because it's... How are you going into the next game? That's such a big game.
They've had a brilliant couple of years. They never had successive top seven finishes in the top division. Arsenal desperate for a return to the Champions League, led again by Martin Odegaard with Lacazette on the bench. Our match commentators here at the London Stadium.
Tommy Asper. Oh, we've got Tommy. Oh, why do we have to lose Tony for fucks?
For a top seven finish with the attempt to reach the Europa League final is again the dilemma for David Moyes. As has been the case for the majority of the European campaign, he rested Lucas Fabianski for Thursday's first leg defeat by Eintracht Frankfurt. Craig Dawson's suspension and Ben Johnson failing a leg fitness test complicates his defensive choices. Kurt Zouma has
chance
to play a second game in 4 days after his wrist ankle injury. And Ryan Fredericks comes in, though where he plays remains to be seen. It could be on the left of a back four. Mark Noble gets another start as his senior career winds down. Jared Byrne, who was rested for the defeat at Chelsea, plays today as one of six starters who also began the Frankfurt match. He saw that Diop edges closer to a first team return after initial fears that he could miss the remainder of the season. Tottenham's win shifts the pressure back onto Mikel Arteta's Arsenal in the chase for Champions League football. Aaron Ramsdale is one of the eight in this team that also started the 3-1 victory against Manchester United. Takahiro Tomiyasu's first start since New Year's Day is counterbalanced by Ben White's absence with a tight hamstring. Rob Holding steps in. Mohamed Elneny and Granit Xhaka are both enjoying late season revivals after earlier frustrations. Bukayo Saka is fit after concerns over a thigh injury last week, but Arteta chooses to promote Gabriel Martinelli in place of Emile Smith-Rowe. And Eddie Nketiah is still trusted to find the goals that could get Arsenal into Europe's top competition next season, even though there are no guarantees that either he or Alexandre Lacazette would be part of such a campaign. Smith, what a servant this man has been.
Yeah, gets a rare start today, Mark Noble, and the clock is fast ticking down on his career. So he'll be treasuring special days like this. It's his last London derby, so he won't want to waste 1 minute of the next 90.
Two managers who know each other so well, a very fruitful partnership they had together at Everton. It was David Moyes who gave Arteta his debut there. Big game for both.
Come on!
Well, it was a fairly turbulent start to life here for West Ham United. But this place really is starting to feel like home now. Partly down to their European ventures.
That's a goal already!
In the latest one here. On the Thursday night, they found themselves a goal down inside 50 seconds. They've conceded a corner very early here through Aaron Cresswell.
Yeah, West Ham want to set the tone here. They were flat on Thursday, never really got going. So, London derby, the last one of the season for them. It's a big day. Perhaps an even bigger one for the Gunners, though.
Yes, the heat. Back on Arsenal with Spurs' victory over Leicester in the earlier game. Saka swings in his corner, which West Ham deal with. It is the Arsenal skipper, again, Odegaard, who gets it back to Mohamed Elneny. Gabriel staying forward, and the clearing header is by Sofal. And it does look as though Fredericks is operating.
Why do I always see a car on the top of the road?
Over five against Chelsea, but that was just matching up with.
I remember the cul-de-sac, it could be so. Shit.
Trying to draw that corner area now. Granit Xhaka came back at him and ends up giving away the free kick.
He's enjoyed a fantastic season, Jared Bowen. He was excellent again on Thursday, hit the post and the bar. Such a handful. Through the middle.
Oh, yeah, I'm having more distractions than I'm going to
do. Well, they made the best of the free kick. And Arsenal regaining possession, although Gabriel promptly gives it away to Saeed Benrahma. But the slot start by both. Here's Cresswell. And this is a surprise to see Aaron Cresswell playing at centre half in a back four. Although David Moyes. Choices today were complicated by the absence of Ben Johnson, who was given a fitness test a couple of hours before kick-off, one that he failed.
It should be a good opportunity for Eddie Nketiah, who's in fine form himself. been hoping he can get a few chances against this makeshift West Ham back four. Here's Rice. Now Kurt Zouma, who's return to fitness is a real bonus for West Ham. Through the middle looking here for Jared Bowen. What holding got to it? And therefore now has had the right kind of idea to look for Jared Bowen again, but Arsenal wise to it.
Yeah, Rob Holding hasn't started many. He had a shaky time at Chelsea a week or so back in that first half. He grew into the game, but his match rustiness did show at Stamford Bridge early on.
It's the look-up of the Ben White-Gabriel partnership is one that extends back pretty much to September. That rare outing recently for Holding was as part of a back three, when Mikel Arteta changed his shape to accommodate the opponents they were playing.
And the boots on the other foot from last week when Arsenal beat Manchester United at lunchtime, and Spurs went up to Brentford later on in the day.
Couldn't get any. 27th point.
Pressure turns to Arsenal now after that really emphatic win over Leicester by Spurs.
To the final month of the season, in 21 days' time, all fates will have been decided. Arsenal may not have reckoned in too many people's predictions at the start of this season for a top four finish, but having put themselves in a position to earn it, the last thing they want to do is see it slip away now. Here's Nuno Tavares, who had a very up and down game against Manchester United, scoring his first goal but giving away a penalty. We also saw the good and the bad, a cheap yellow card followed by a goal that ultimately clinched the game. Sinclair's header, which Noble was unable to connect
the
with.
Excitement.
Here's Martin Odegaard.
The clock won't, yeah. It's only been 5 minutes.
It's Ketia, first goal. Not to any great Arsenal
advantage. Oi! Don't jinx it!
Four minutes.
Yeah, not much.
Not
that.
Are you sitting like that in?
Oh, yeah, we'll do, yeah.
Cushions.
You know what? That's what the final score was.
Sugar.
And the women's game.
To Eddie and Ketty,
whose
future Arsenal has still
did
to be
sorted out. Yeah, 7-0.
What?
Who's
that
then?
To sign another contract.
You put in the.
Not Mr. Dean.
He's a week short of 35.
Fantastic career. Time running through his veins.
He was actually a schoolboy at Arsenal from the age of 12. But he's never ever scored a senior goal against them.
Well, Arsenal do boast a great record in the Premier League. West Ham's match, don't they? Whether it's here or Upton Park, a great record.
Single point.
They're aware the players will be at that. Mikel Arteta. If it makes any difference at all.
Yes. Looking to make inroads.
Yeah? No, not yet.
What?
Oh, yeah. Back to Edge of the Station. When they left. They didn't want it.
Shaka. Deception by Crosswell, and he'll rely on the sense of anticipation. And Rama has Fredericks moving on ahead of him. It's a back now for Manuel Lanzini. Here's Crosswell. Noble.
this sooner.
He was quite a while though.
He was quite a while, so when he was an end, so.
Situation, only the top two ahead of them. No Thomas Sojak in the team today, but still plenty to aim at. And in trying to put the pressure on Ramsdale, the Arsenal goalkeeper resists.
Yeah, we stood a little shove, I think, as it came in. Took in the shirt, perhaps, but I think just enough. But now it's Sojak Dawson as well, who's been a real handful from set pieces.
So far, Noble. Right idea to try and slot it into four now. Pick up their club by
come on!
Xhaka sweeps it away to Odegaard. It's Tomiyasu. Now, Bukayo Saka, who's scored from the penalty spot in each of Arsenal's last two matches. Seeking their first top four finish in 6 years since the season when Leicester won the title. And here's Aminel Nevi looking for Martinelli's run. Noble. Isn't the team still wears the captain's armband despite that being more in the possession of Declan Rice for the majority of this Premier League campaign. There's Ryan Fredericks. To Zouf. He played alongside Mikel Arteta in his own Arsenal days on the FA Cup. Alongside him in his final appearance for the Gunners.
Hello! How are you doing?
I'm doing sweet. He works for Dexter.
Everything.
The camera, I've been in the past.
He's silly, Billy. Oh, gosh. Hello, mate.
Clearance.
Yeah, the role of Martin Odegaard is important, and he's just drifted in from that right-hand side of midfield. Quite often, Declan Rice is looking as to his whereabouts. Oh, yeah,
so just make him cup two. He's only cup two, apparently.
You can make your own team, don't you see? I'll just get through the ball.
Here's Gabriel. Now Tomiyasu. Zuma. Start, not the kind you so often see in derbies. It's fast and furious, it's over at the moment. Mm. As you say, it is West Ham's final London derby of the season, their penultimate home game. Only Manchester City still to visit after this. Won by Ødegaard, and Ketia feeding it back to Elneny, who was just caught by Kurt Zuma. Feels the effects, the Egyptian. Just on the stretch, he was only second best for that Zuma. Well, even though it might be different to their long-term record at West Ham, Mikel Arteta will certainly remember their visit here last year when he said that we saw both faces on Arsenal when there were three goals down. For a little over half an hour, and yet still managed to get a point out of the match.
Yeah, the team's developed since those days when it could be quite hectic in terms of defending. I quite knew it was going to happen. There's a consistency to the play now.
Here's Bukayo Saka, and he goes for goal, and Aaron Cresswell is in the way of the shot. Initially by Ben Rama, but Saka's picked it up again. Looks to leave it for Nketiah. There's Elneny. Now Xhaka.
Yes,
dude.
Since your dad didn't
make
ready to make
you one. Xhaka really intended. He didn't
really catch it cleanly, Granit Xhaka. Have a cook if you want
a bit, Jim. That's all right.
Hello,
yeah. It depends.
You
get
a new
score, you know,
to what sort of reaction
you're
going to get.
What was that? I've got the right shot on
me
today.
Yeah, so Andrew went back out and dead.
Not into Andrew to the station?
Yeah, that's right.
Ketia takes it off the turn and
corner, but I don't know why he didn't just let it off to the wing.
Yeah, that's a little glimpse of the level of confidence he's playing with at the moment. 25 yards out to that one.
It's our first team struggle at the moment.
Against Tavares and then hunt down by his opponent.
Midfield.
quite often Martin will be shooting inside and allow Tavares to provide width on that left flank. Delivery this one, really difficult to defend against, but Fabianski gets a really good punch on it under pressure.
All those players! There's always that many players.
As much as anything, that caused him to go down. A fairly traumatic career at Arsenal, did Lucas Fabianski, affected his confidence considerably, but rebuilt his career so well at Swansea and continued that here in East London.
I've got Dad, Jeff, whatever you want to call him.
Dad is to you.
That is his name. Jeff.
High on West Ham's defence as they play it out. They've just withdrawn there into their shape.
Who's that?
That's me. You win the prize, actually. The loudest.
Fredericks.
Trying to keep mine under control.
Patient approach play this by West Ham so far. Really are missing a focal point of their attack again though as they look to play their way through.
Was that a plan?
Who's that strange looking bloke? He's not playing for you.
I bet you like that.
What's his name?
Tomiyasu.
The best pass would be.
He's just come back from England. He played like 20 minutes on the bench.
He did start the last Premier League match, but hasn't and this still remains. Started back to back Premier League matches in some 2.5 years. Now Xhaka. There will be space in the middle of the park. You can see West Ham drop back. In the deep line. Tomiyasu. Here's Nketiah. Tavares. Nice. Tavares was aware of it, set up too early anyway, and would have been offside. He's just held onto it for a fraction too long. Here's Tavares. Martinelli reacted late to the danger of Jared Bowen there. Is judged to have put away the free kick. There's a poor pass by Tavares, put his teammate in all sorts of bother. Bellini. Here's Tomiyasu. Tavares. Gabriel. Sort of a little half pace at the moment. Neither side able to get behind the opposing defence. Just lack of intensity from both sides. Gabriel. Had a little bit of space for El Neni. Odegaard. Rice just got a foot to it, and Lanzini starts the building process to get away, and it doesn't last long. Here's Tavares, there's Xhaka. Tavares with the ball across that Zuma stands up to. Four outs. Lanzini couldn't reach him. Probably sums up the first 23, 24 minutes. Just been a lack of quality out there. Well, this West Ham have probably got the greater reasoning for the lack of intensity, bearing in mind that they were only playing 3 days ago. So you would have expected to be the fresher, maybe the team, and particularly bearing in mind their own good start against Manchester United and West Ham's awful start here on Thursday, might have been prepared to get out of the blocks a bit more rapidly.
Yeah, it's been a game of the week practically for Arsenal for a long time there, so physically they should have the advantage.
But they do want to put themselves into a position where they are playing more games and at the very top level of Europe as well. There's Tomiyasu. Lennon. You're Tomiyasu finding Gabriel. Now holding. Tavares. Martinelli closed down by Noble. Here's Odegaard. Steps Noble, keeps it simple, finds Kurt Zuma. He's just been looked out of his stride by Odegaard and finds Saeed Benrahma. Takes him to Miyatsu. And Zuma's still up there, it's blocked by Holden, and El Neni gets it away. And looking at what part of the body blocked that header from Kurt Zuma. And the check is very rapidly completed with nothing coming out of it. Holding it was in the way of Kurt Zuma's header. Chance manufactured from this side by Saeed Benrahma. And where West Ham are looking for joy again.
Zuma was up there. Position.
So far, now Crosswell.
Yeah,
it's
a bit dull.
It's like, oh, it's straining my eyes.
Yeah, it's the TV. I was going to say, did you want to have it?
That's fine.
Yeah,
that's
better like that.
So far. Both for Fornals is controlled.
Oh, I like your picture.
The initial ball at him, couldn't control the shot.
It's a bit dark, isn't it? Probably could be.
It's volley, but not the best defensive header by any means from Gabriel.
Get
any vital distance.
But we can just change the brightness.
This is his shape bit. Or else you wouldn't expect that from him.
Oh, yeah, of course. Do you know how to do the brightness on next day?
It looks fine now.
No, it is a bit dull.
Well,
there's certainly no sun out.
No,
no, look, it's like
come on. Come on! What's the ball, Tommy?
Martinelli's held his wick for the most part in this half. He's been playing in a kind of inside left position. And it's been Tavares offering the pass on this side. Xhaka awaits the corner here from Gabriel Martinelli. And again, they try to plant it directly onto Lucas Fabianski. Dangerous one, that was a bit too floaty and too close.
Excuse you.
Although this is West Ham's final derby, Arsenal have a very significant one still looming on the 12th of May at Tottenham Hotspur Stadium. Keeping ahead of Spurs in that game is very much the need. Here's Vladimir so far, trying to drive it over the crossbar. It's blocked. It was Jesus who came in with a shot, and it was blocked by Rob Holding. Yeah, signs that the home team are warming up here. Danger signals for Arsenal. We've had a couple of good moments in the last couple of minutes. That one nearly blocking. Two key blocks already from Rob Holding. Here's Fredericks. Did really well to keep that in, Bukayo Saka. Runs at Declan Rice.
Come on, come on.
It's Eddie Nketiah.
Oh.
Lingard was waiting on it. And which way was going to, which way that was going to go, but Saka got out of such a tight corner. And it's never a surprise with this, but his balance, his control, he's spot on. So often he's been the one that's come up with the inspiration for Arsenal, and they need a bit at the moment. To three Europa League campaigns, but I'm sure he would be absolutely delighted to take his place on the Champions League stage, Bukayo Saka, which is the aim, and it is within sight for Arsenal if they can keep up the winning run they've had recently, right to the end of the season. It does have to be a win today for Arsenal if they are to clamber above Spurs following their success earlier. Benrahma, Cresswell, now Fredericks.
It's too much that you have to sit there forever. You can.
Assistant on his side, didn't flag. But, you know, stuck on the shoulder.
Depends on what time you do a couple of cups.
Yes, Zuma.
We need the usual sort of silly last
second. Yeah. the set was on for the morning last night.
Yeah. No shots on target in the whole match.
Goalkeepers. Oh, they got the gloves warm yet. The job has been done for him so far by the players in front of him, holding, stopping a couple of West Ham attempts. Yes, West Ham are just starting to show one or two more signs of taking charge. Declan Rice looking to reinforce that position. And the shot is
straight. Steve, your face.
Choice of line for Edwards to his left, who is in all sorts of space, but there was a shot on here, and I'm not waiting for taking
it. I know,
just get Steve to take all the bits off.
I'm right, so I don't, are you sure?
West Ham looking the most likely, the more likely at the moment. Ødegaard. Now on Nenny. This is Nketiah. Just about got there ahead of Fornals. And Xhaka's ball across. And Nketiah is unable to control.
Yeah,
he cut short there, and nobody from the West Ham back four showed an inclination to go in on him.
I've only seen West Ham down there in lane, though.
Chris! Miss!
Otherwise, the gap gets filled up with a load of.
Yeah.
Run, run, run!
There goes Nuno Tavares, looking to exploit the freedom of the central area, but Nuno picks his pocket. Four downs.
Yeah, eh?
Here's Bayern, give it a look.
Give it out there, it's cold.
Martin Ødegaard.
Hold your baby, mate.
Now, Eddie Nketiah trying to find a
pass. Oh!
He has to make the
His first serious save. Yeah, Arsenal's best moment.
First blessing.
Too much competition, but he did all open up. Ian Moore, the Gunners sport, Eddie and Ketia, who we've seen on many occasions. He's a really accomplished finisher. Has to demand a good save from Fabianski. By West Ham giving Arsenal encouragement. They're still in a position to take advantage of it here. As Saka swings in the corner.
Yes! Holding! Holding!
Is that unusual?
Yeah, the guy, he's just coming for someone that was injured.
When you look at the identity of the goal scorer, Ron Holding,
with his first ever Arsenal flares down there for his matches.
His first ever Premier League goal?
Initially, he's seen number 16 in yellow. Lanzini just can't compete physically. He brushes him off. After that, it's a really good lead, but a lovely glance from the centre half. That. Lift the match as a whole. Just what Arsenal were after. Sheer delight for Aaron Ramsdale, but Ron Holding had only ever scored one league goal in his career before today, and that was in the Championship for Bolton Wanderers. Steps up now with.
Is that unusual then for a bloke of his position to score?
With which they started the day.
We've just got to defend better now.
Shouldn't have picked up. Home crowd will be demanding more. Course will be lifted. This team won't be so good at attacking.
We were so quiet and then
here. Got a chance to repair things from a corner of their own, which Arsenal getting a taste of their own. It was a wonderful reaction stop from Aaron Ramsdale to deny Declan Rice. Near post run from Boyce. I think he's just trying to flick it on rather than going for goal. Very nearly hitting straight back here, the Hammers. Conor Gordon just trying to head it back into an area as it turned down. It's on target.
Look
at that on his toes. Here's Saka, now Tomiyasu.
Saka will be last before all time. That's how it stands.
It's changed the shape of the Premier League pursuit, but placing the Champions League now with Arsenal as it stands.
Tottenham 3-1
earlier. On their North London rivals.
I don't know when Tottenham make Liverpool at Anfield is going to be the goal difference in Liverpool.
There's Shaka.
There she is. Oh, be careful.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Frederick's now Rice.
This guy doesn't even run fast.
Is it nicked away from him?
I mean, what? Well, I mean, but he doesn't run fast, but no one's trying to go into a tackle.
Steps in here for West Ham. For Niles. So far, with the cross, but not for them to take advantage of holding score at one end, defends it at the other.
Yeah. Just reaching out for that. Have to make sure he got the elevation on the header.
You will know that on Catsball, it's not all over yet. They've conceded first.
Oh yeah, Chelsea can just
score on different occasions this season, but they come back to win. Looks as though West Ham are determined to open up Arsenal in the same way that they've been opening up themselves with those near post corners being flicked on. See what was up for that one, couldn't get to it. Yeah.
against Newcastle, Leeds, Chelsea and Watford already this season. If West Ham conceded first, but gone on to win, was at least touched by Martinelli. Blown for a free kick with a challenge on Nketiah.
Saw it coming, Nketiah. What you have to do in that set of make sure you protect the ball. It's a strange one, he's put Lanzini onto Mark, holding Lanzini, probably the smallest man on the pitch, marking one of the opposition centre halves.
Excuse you.
Oh, Mark, come on. How many times have we given it away?
It's Bowen. What else? So if I can't shake off Granit Xhaka. It's loose from Tavares.
Shit, come on. Phone, keep just starting the apps.
It's Fredericks. Rose is coming in around the back, a couple of touches ahead of him. No ball. Cleared by Holding. And back out to Fredericks. This is Cresswell. Rice. Space if his time is wrong, right? Frank does stay down, it's pulled back for Jack. And that's the character that's been a hallmark of West Ham United season.
Oi!
Well, it doesn't come as a huge surprise, and certainly not surprised the identity of the goal scorer. And all sorts of space on this right hand side to deliver into the box. Times is right. Really well, stays onside, it looks like, but shouldn't have that much space. It does take an inflection, but Rowan's got all sorts of time to take his touch and look up. Coming off Gabriel to beat Wells down.
I'm standing in the wrong place, Steve. The Arsenal players. He's a pig.
Relief as much as anything else for David Moyes, Jared Bowen into double figures in the Premier League for goals now this season. And on his 100th appearance for West Ham, he has something to celebrate. Control shot that deflected past Aaron Ramsdale, got the equaliser, and at half time it is West Ham 1, Arsenal 1.
Rollo E-Tech, reuniting fans of the Premier League on Sky Sports.
Rob and Ramesh are back to discover some brave new worlds.
You're talking about a lie!
Sorry. Yeah.
Is that serious?
Yes!
We all fantasize about our perfect home.
But let's get real for a minute. For a start, who are these guys? And what's going on here?
The perfect office space? Think again. So if you're serious about making your fantasy a reality,
enter your postcode now to find out your home's sale or rental valuation estimate instantly. Get real about moving. Get on the market.
Sheets for cool cats. There's a small business on eBay for that. Smartphones, headphones, that's my brush. There's a small business for that. Bathroom tiles, bath bombs, bomber jackets. There's a small business for that. Missed a bit. Icing hits, ice packs, even a herb that comes flat pack. For real. There's over 300,000 small businesses for all that. Even that.
Introducing Chase, the digital bank that makes every day rewarding.
In what way?
When you bank with Chase, you can earn 1.5% interest on your Chase Saver account.
Great.
Now I can save for a real holiday.
Can I create a Chase Saver account for a wedding?
Mm-hmm. First time.
Children?
Yeah, you can add up to 10 separate saver accounts.
This is our first date.
Yeah, I'll leave you to it.
Could I access my savings instantly without fees to buy this?
Well,
sure,
well,
I'll just get 1% cash back on your usual
Chase debit
card.
That's nice of
you, isn't it? See the look of a
you're giving yourself an awful lot. Great big
big
full of
these. Big
yeah,
names.
Let's get rid of it in one
we got big names, big time. Order now.
If somebody says just eat.
Amazing deals now on at Currys, and with our price promise, you won't get it cheaper. Save up to £100 and get free recycling on these hot boy extra large 10 kilo washers, now just £2.99. Or save up to £130 on these LG Nano Cell 4K TVs with a fast quad-core processor for refined picture and sound from just £379. This Dyson purifier with its powerful air multiply technology captures everyday pollutants for just £499. And why not save £100 on these Asus 15.6-inch Full HD laptop with 16GB of Intel Optane memory? Now only £379 at Currys.
Challenge your tape.
I've got this bubbling sensation, a sensory celebration. Pepsi Max, maximum taste, no sugar.
Hey, Barry here. I joined GiveGaff in 2011 and I've stayed ever since. What I love is there's no stress. The value and flexibility is fantastic. They've also fixed their UK prices this year, so even if my bills go up elsewhere, I've got one less thing to worry about. Thanks, GiveGaff. After 11 years, I'm still in the right place.
With flexible plans, great value, and fixed UK prices for 2022. GiveGaff gives back.
School. It's more than a school.
Getting into your flow. It's all about how you start. New Gillette Labs with exfoliating bar. Clears a bath on your skin before the blades for effortless shaving and exfoliation in one stroke. Because when you start in flow, you're quicker to your best. Put your best face forward with the new Gillette Labs range. Gillette, the best a man can get.
Run out your tech. Reuniting fans with the Premier League on Sky Sports.
Well, if you thought that West Ham United were just going to roll over here this afternoon, think again. What a piece at half-time. Arsenal scored first. Did the spark for them, Jermaine, come from Eddie Nketiah?
Yeah, I think he's been brilliant. I think, you know, the way he's played, everything's come up to him. That's been
what? You're probably just going to run away again.
He's mixing up his movement. He's coming
straight
to the
point.
He's
going
long, getting behind. He gets a little ball here, cuts inside.
Unlucky.
You see what he's trying to do with the finish. You know, being a keeper is...
But from that corner, they can see Jamie. West Ham United missing Socek today. Craig Dawson as well. Has that cost them?
Absolutely, because they don't be so good at defensive set pieces. You can see he gets through the additional block there. Lanzini's trying to block him. They don't have a man on the back post. If they did, he'd just clear that away. But West Ham are normally so good at set pieces. But you can see he gets involved in a fight. He gets up early above Zuma. Really good header, Rob Holgan.
But have we seen again, Graham, the toughness that's in this West Ham team?
Yeah, they've shown it all year, though. You know, they never give up. They've got resilience to come back like this. A great pen from Declan Rice. Good chest control from Kufal. Difficult ball for Jarrod Bowen to control and got off his shot all in one movement, more or less. That was a super goal. And I guess a wee bit of luck with the deflection. But this is nice touch, nice pen. playing. Not that is not easy. It's bouncing just before it comes to ball. He manages to get under control. We've got a lot with a deflection here.
So as you hear that, it's not even a chance really. When Paul's coming to him, and what he's done there is just improvised. And you know, the way he just controlled his body, and obviously got a slight deflection, a little bit of luck in that, but good finish.
Oh, it's
why do you think it took so long for the game to burst into life?
I don't know, he just needed to respond someone just to do something special, get on it and have a shot at goal. And after obviously Arsenal got the goal and that, and then West Ham, they made a habit of it coming back from being in a losing position and getting their goal back.
Big sways of this stadium silenced by Rob Holding's first ever Premier League goal for Arsenal. That put them in front. But goodness me, even Norwich Devils cranked up with Jared Bowen's equaliser just before half time.
West Ham goal? Yeah.
Ronald Itek, reuniting fans with the Premier League on Sky Sports.
Litre Ducks Back Shed and Fence Treatment for just £8. Don't be house embarrassed, be house proud with Wickes.
For a limited time only, buy what, two and get the third free on full price Pandora jewellery. Ends 8th of May. Terms and exclusions apply.
At NFU Mutual, we believe in quality car and home insurance. That's why 9 out of 10 customers renew with us each year. Call now or search NFU Mutual.
Wouldn't it be nice to keep hold of things you'd normally lose? Yes, come on! Sky Mobile rolls with spare data so you can keep hold of it for up to 3 years. Sky Mobile. Hello, possible.
When it feels like money's tight, it's good to know that at Tesco, we price match hundreds of products that matter most to you right now. So you can be sure you'll find the things you need to make the meals you know and love. Like this pasta bake that feeds four for only £3.64. Because right now, every little helps.
When we all play the National Lottery a little, fun stuff happens near you. From clean beaches to bringing history to life, funding museums, supporting inspiring music programs, and helping people explore the great outdoors. £30 million a week to good causes. The National Lottery. Your numbers make amazing happen.
I don't want
I don't want praise, I don't want pity. I'm so old, and my love is sparkle and it's bang on. Why not see things from a different angle? Your life is a sham too. You can't shout out, I got one.
This will change driving forever, Sergey. It's completely automated.
Are you sure?
Of course. You can really just let go and relax.
Okay.
Sergey, what are you doing?
Well, you said it was automated.
Well, the car. The car insurance.
I check the new deals automatically. Oh, I see. Nick, up your car insurance to automatically find ways to save. Simples.
Whatever you do, keep
stupid fresh.
Family is all we got.
We stick together and we love each other.
Who's there? Dad found me at the bottom of the stairs.
We believe Michael Peterson murdered Kathleen in cold blood.
It's my life on the line.
I'm sorry.
I want to tell my story.
What's that
place
for? It's alright,
just
get a
little fuck
over there.
Selena, don't throw your life away.
Don't worry,
honey.
I am nine of them.
The Batman.
I am what I am.
Run on E-Tech, reuniting fans with the Premier League of Sky Sports.
We end the weekend with Manchester United's final home game of the season. They're taking on Brentford tomorrow night. Roy Keane will join us. He's picking his best ever Manchester United 11 as part of the programme. That's from 7. You'll see United again the following Saturday at Brighton, who picked up some form, haven't they, at the back end of this season. Super Sunday next week, Arsenal again against Leeds, now in relegation bother. We're on from 1 o'clock, and we're also watching Manchester City as they continue their pursuit of the title against Newcastle United. That's from 4. And we've seen Everton win today, we've seen Spurs win today, and we are nicely poised at half-time at the London Stadium.
Introducing TUI Blue, our own collection of premium hotels designed for you to live happy at all protected.
So, what all at half time?
Arsenal, all right, thank you.
Outside the top four.
What
have you made of their approach so far?
I've been patient. I mean, I've had most of the ball. They've got to be more threatening here. For them, they'll have to do.
You
have to come from this game. So I think they'll have to be a little bit more.
I'll be asleep. I'll be asleep. I'll be asleep.
By the front foot, you've got to be working the goalkeeper. I've not done that enough. They need to win this game.
I think he wants a little bit more from Martinelli. And I think in 10, 15 minutes, if he isn't starting to get involved, I can see more
Smith-Rowe
come on. I think that might be a really good option with his pace and skill in that area. But I think the disappointment will be getting that foothold in the game and then to concede just before half time.
And what about the West Ham United approach? Will he, David Moyes, want to keep Mikel Antonio in reserve for as long as possible, Jermaine?
Yeah, of course, it's a massive game on a Thursday, so of course, at some point, he's going to have to bring him on. If it's 1-1, he's going to bring him on to try and get, especially the way they're playing, the ball's down right, not really crossing the box. You know, a lot of possession, going side to side, but not really getting balls in the box. And I think he's obviously a threat in the box, so at some stage he'll come on.
I've really enjoyed the battle between Declan Rice and Odegaard. It's been fascinating, and he feels like one of those two players trying to get the other side. Odegaard picks up great positions, Declan Rice is drawn from midfield as well.
And a lot of loss of possession, Jim.
Well, let's have that. You can hear the bubbles. Alan Smith and Rob Hawthorn.
Even things up. You can see he had given the ball away in the build up to the corner that led to Arsenal's opening goal from Rob Holding before himself cancelling out that opener with West Ham United's equaliser. So, all to play for, as we saw from the as it stands table, for serious movement for either of these teams, it has to be a win because victory would take West Ham above Manchester United in the table on goal difference, and only a victory would put Arsenal ahead of Spurs. after Tottenham's earlier victory. So very much all to play for in the second half for both managers. Managers who enjoyed a 6.5 year partnership together that yielded 4 finishes in the top 6 and the same number of European campaigns when they were together at Everton. Yeah, when you look at it on paper, a draw isn't a terrible result for Arsenal, given they've just beaten Chelsea and Manchester United. But having seen the first 45, I'm sure Arteta thinks this is the game we could win and perhaps should win if we could step it up, which they managed to do. Yeah. Second half goals from Martinelli and Smith Rowe. They've yet to beat any of their league rivals home and away this season. Here's Tavares. Now Granit Xhaka coming under pressure from Mark Noble.
3. That's alright. Got it.
Because
I didn't charge it.
No. Here's Zuma. Now Noble. So Carl finding his room down the touchline, limited.
His shoulders. I've got that bag out upstairs with those two dresses on.
It's Fredericks.
Oh, yeah, Roderick.
I see what the switchers on to Valeria so far.
But I've never, I don't think I will have.
What else?
To who? But they're only 12. That's
it. He's dribbled to it and the block is by Holding.
It would probably
be. He's back on it, but he did enough.
They're pretty. Right. Rather than. Yeah, I'll have a look.
Here's Cresswell. Now Bowen. Just before to the spot, Bukayo Saka was a clip on the ankles, which brings Saka a yellow card. One of those passages of play, though, a little deep ball up to Bowen.
Oh, he's got a card, Steve.
Chested it down in the dark, but you don't normally see that. There's not enough time on the ball. As a rule in these kind of contests, but there has been today. Starting the season at Brentford and the climax of the campaign is somewhat heavy with these cross London trips. Brentford's looking to put a lot of pressure here. It's a big line going towards Ben Rama, but Tobias who just shields it from him. Frederick's actually doing a good job from left back.
Absolutely like.
Six Premier League away matches in this campaign. We'll have come against rival teams in the capital. They lost at Brentford and Palace, but they lost away win at Chelsea. Really did
play off the team.
Massive spring in their step.
Because he's an old fuddy daddy.
Yes, he's
mine.
He
loves going outside, Dexter. But you're not being nice
today. Nice climbing.
There's
old Lenny.
Got more,
Steve.
Two glasses.
It's a whole jar.
Blimey. I have to drink it all at once.
Yes, Rob.
I think it's the best. Space it out a bit.
Just give us a.
Frederick's.
Don't set a warning. Why can't you keep one till tomorrow?
That's
alright.
It takes that bad, you want to just get it over.
You know, people make themselves like a smoothie. Or whatever it is every day, but they don't
first
drink 1.5 pints of it.
No, that's a lot, isn't it?
Martinelli. He can bag his most fullbacks. Cresswell. Here's Fredericks. Rommel pulls it back. Fornals was just waiting on it. Kettier finds Bukayo Saka.
Come on, Eddie. Kettier
gets going again. Martinelli was just a little behind him. Any options ahead? Tagliazzi getting into trouble there against Lanzini and Ben Rama, but Arsenal do well to win it back. Saka has been in too much time and no more powered in.
He was just asleep.
Saka still on the
pitch. Come and get up.
Yes, Saka.
Here he comes. No, referee's not taking any notice of me, so I'll get up.
Arsenal will get away again and block through the middle here. What's that?
Oh.
Thanks, that has to go.
Has he brought you down? No.
Martin's giving it the other way.
It's a dive.
For Jared Bowen. Well, he must have got some advice off his
shit, you told the deflected goal.
Defensive duties here for West Ham, and who picks up holding this time? Now the closest. Probably it's a man-to-man system, we're just trying to block him, but Lanzini couldn't do it. So they're planting another one in there towards the danger man. It's going to break here for Martinelli. Charles one back in, Gabriel! Check on the goal is complete, so it is going to count for Gabriel.
come off the back of so far. Here you are. Have a look. And it's 2-1.
Come on, but hold on, this time.
He was going to say, what should have saved him? Well, I mean, he was point blank range, wasn't it? Sometimes you need a bit of luck as a keeper. He was almost falling backwards. There's a lot of power on the header.
That was Gabriel Martinelli to Gabriel. Oh, I can't pronounce his last name.
So Arsenal back in top position. The ever-changing situation on this Sunday afternoon in that battle for a Champions League place next season. Just turning into a two-horse race between the North London rivals who meet up later this month. Crossrail under pressure. Just that pressure from Martinelli. Oh, it might turn out to be a big couple of minutes. Ryan Jarrod Bowen wants to be, and the bumps don't sent off, but circumstances been different.
As
it is at the other end, Arsenal take the lead.
Stop your hand ball when it's not fucking control the ball, you stupid fucking idiot. Sorry! I'm gonna send you out!
Washing
out about the soap and water. Here's Tavares. He's got
away from so far this time. Oh, come on. Two goal lead would be nice. I was just like, I'll never forget the time that I've done it, but one of Dan's friends was married to an American girl named Laura.
Ah, what was that? Martinelli, you're not Jacka, mate.
And then Martin's dad, he's a big Baggies West Brom fan.
Oh, wow.
So he took me and Laura to the football match. She was just going to watch a football match. It was like, so we met Mark's dad. And of course, this is like her father. But then a little as soon as we got into football match, he's like, yeah. Laura was like, oh my God. Like, you know what blokes are like at football matches, and something turned into this, like, she was like, oh my God. Because they'd, like, obviously never seen anything like that in front of her before.
No.
She thought it was hilarious.
Good.
Which was quite funny.
Probably
the only
time that you
would ever.
No.
Yeah, exactly.
Martinelli. Again, Gabriel Martinelli, and Kettia takes over.
Oh, come on, we need that all put on that goal.
Here's for Miles. Closing down and adding more to his game and being simply a poacher.
Still half a fucking hour to go.
Excuse me.
Sorry.
Well, I should get that square box out, I'd make a fortune.
Piggy bank soon.
I got a fiver, will that cover it?
Pardon?
I got a fiver, will that cover it? Isn't it a pound in the square box?
No, five.
What, every time I swear?
Yeah, that's
what
you're doing.
Doing
it.
Size earlier in the season, same time that he gave away a penalty that Arsenal missed.
Might as well put a tenner in there and that'll cover you for the rest of the match.
Oh God, come on, man.
Here's Xhaka. So far.
Come on! I stand fair to keep rebounding every time we get a free kick.
It was here that Gabriel Martinelli made the first start of his Premier League career. Scored well in a 3-1 win that they achieved under caretaker manager Frank Lampard.
All right.
You're right.
Yeah. It's all right. It's just a bit towards the end. It's a bit, you know.
You're drinking too much of it. You had a few big glasses there.
Noble. Lanzini. Stayed out on that right. Here's Zuma.
God. Come on.
Katie are coming under immediate pressure from Zuma. They find himself surrounded. Really well. You do well, but one thing you don't do is lose it
then. Yeah,
except
for forgiving him for kicking his cat,
yeah, or whatever.
Bring the tempo back to make it more labour to frustrate West Ham. Saka with a flick on. Here's Mark Noble.
I've never yawned so much in my life.
Swept wide back on the last two.
It's ridiculous.
So far.
A lot of different things, isn't
it? Yeah.
The travelling.
True.
And
Yeah.
I'm just watching that. Now, I had a really busy day for you.
Oh. Yeah.
Well, actually, the first time. Thursday, I really stopped the lift down. I can't believe it.
I just said to Dan, I'm going to
just look.
Hang on.
I just
said to Dan, I finished my smoothie. Because we got into a costume and I said, and he said, you want another smoothie in the room?
Yeah.
That is the difference, in fact. Obviously, only got 3 days, you know, before going up to five. I'm working from home, so it's more opportunity to like, get obviously,
yeah,
done,
stick your washing in.
Even so, it just feels like you don't have time to do it.
Oh,
no
little break.
So far. Now,
Shaka.
Well,
that's great.
Yeah, it's great. Well, it's great.
More context of what's going on. Yeah. At least he thought it was funny. I think it would be with me, I'd be like,
oh, I don't know if I like that
either. I know.
Well, I'm weird.
Oh, gosh, that's so cute. Oh, come on.
Just as Rob Dean disbelieved him earlier from his game with Ramsdale, so he did again there.
You don't think you should have done it again, do you? After he'd been booked for it.
I don't know, he probably just bought a fallen over or something. I won't be idiotic to do that again.
So just at the moment able to control the game. Accepted the earlier decision of the outcome against him, but still seems to be questioning that one as well.
Oh, Dan loved it.
Arsenal have never lost under Mikel Arteta, or indeed any of the last five meetings between the sides. Here's Lanzini. So far. Something West Ham.
Oh no!
It's precious little sign
of. Who is it?
Finding the equaliser. And Mikel Antonio is coming over to replace Manuel Lanzini. He did score here on Thursday, Antonio, to give West Ham genuine hope going into the second leg of that Europa League semi final against Eintracht. 13 Premier League appearances without a goal for him now. 20 minutes to go. This would be a very good time to end that particular drought
Something different to think about, that's for sure.
Two second halves who have given Arsenal their lead.
He draws a sort of strong.
Yeah, okay.
Here's Antonio.
I know it's still travelling now, but it's like...
Yeah, when you're travelling, you just...
Oh, no! It's not by Gabrielle!
She's a bit of a moment.
There goes
Nketiah
with that.
Come on! Come on!
It's Eddie Nketiah for Arsenal!
Oh!
Well, he factored in so much in that position. He is such a good finisher.
There's a chance for Arsenal here to take the game away from West Ham.
All right, it might have been a bit open, but it really isn't.
Sunday is so busy.
It's the goal still.
£8 if you were doing
the draw. The change continues, and
Thomas Surgery is being prepared. Well, there. There is a opportunity,
but it's so limited. Yeah, it's a
simple.
I think
it's a little bit
long.
But yeah, if you don't get there, it's a little bit. You know, they do get there, it's a little bit.
Struggling to shrug off markers to get there. Yeah, I suppose they've got a slightly bigger target now, somebody who will attack the ball, give it good service in Antonio. A warm live Premier League football for you over this bank holiday weekend. Our Monday night football takes us to Old Trafford. Manchester United against Brentford is live from 7 o'clock.
Oh, yeah.
She did say she'd get a bus back, but that's not right, is it? Leave your mum at the bus stop.
Oh, for a cup of tea. Make you get a bus.
Oh, yeah.
Especially on a Sunday, though.
No,
you can't really have the cars in the background.
Christmas ball in. By Tavares.
In the rain.
Holding firm defensively. And Erdogan sweeping and playing. We get more and more of these kind of opportunities.
Quality!
Petty's movement's been good.
He's got a different colour of ball.
Yeah,
much time.
Fabianski doesn't do West Ham too many favours though, invites pressure back on them. Tomiyasu, now Odegaard, Saka. Tomiyasu with a problem, needs attention, so he puts the ball out. Well, those calf problems. We hope it's not the occurrence of that. Well, in the meantime, West Ham are going to make this change. Probably too many more times, they'll see, but nobody here at the London Stadium. There's only one more chance for him to have an outing here against Manchester City. So you are always wondering when you see his exit whether it is a farewell.
Yeah, it's a West Ham legend. He'll
go down in the history books for what he's given to this club. Didn't look as though Tomiyasu was pointing to the calf area again, which is a concern, seeing as he's had problems with both. And Cedric has to come on for the time that remains him.
Well, Arsenal have got problems in both full-back positions, really. Tavares, you don't quite know what you're going to get off him defensively. He can be suspect. But Tomiyasu has tweaked his calf again. Keep him out. A few weeks. Cedric has had his ups and downs.
Yes,
that
can only win
there to take
the closing.
Yeah.
And then switch it. One more change, and the indications are they're about to use it. Andrei Armalenko's getting ready to call. So David Moyes keen to throw everything at this to get the win that will take them ahead of Manchester United on goal difference.
That's nice, yeah.
This one there.
This one.
This one, Tavares. There's Tom Sochek. That's short. Oh! He's put his goalkeeper in front of him. It's Eddie Nketiah.
Who's she supporting?
It's him.
Why?
It's the corner.
Why?
The corner.
I've always been my favourite
team. So from those, he's got
away
with one here.
So. This
a couple of these kind of chances now.
That's all right.
This one was on top.
West Ham have no chance of getting into the Champions League, so you either have Arsenal or Tottenham in the Champions League. Who do you prefer? You said you didn't like Tottenham yesterday.
No, I don't.
West Ham is where our family roots are from, Steve.
Yeah, it's where our family comes from.
Lifted in.
From East London.
Actually favoured Fabianski in the way that he delivered it.
So you've been a traitor by being an Arsenal supporter.
How?
West Ham fans, willing to reaction. Push, there hasn't been too much difference since Antonio came on. Arsenal have been pretty comfortable defensively.
With his. With his dad's side of them. Well, today was the logic's one.
Yes,
Cresswell. Was his standing as well to start with.
Yeah,
Zuma.
Yeah.
It's a subject.
buzzing cross put into the area. West Ham have manned. There's a cross that ball, Blackstar for approximately a second. Couldn't get to it.
Arteta just keeping the ball away from Chris Wilder. Delaying material because West Ham wants to make a substitution anyway. So Saïd Benrahma is going off, and on in his place is Andre Yarmolenko.
Put two taps on, Steve.
What?
I think, have they put two taps on, or one tap?
As long as we defend well, it doesn't really matter.
Into the action, Yarmolenko. Clever first touch, back to Thomas Sojic. Now for Nals.
I saw a thing.
There's frustration for Yarmolenko as the flag goes up.
I spoke with him.
All these cards now.
By the time he kind of got the drink, the like other side has gone two goals once he was away. Oh, God.
Oh, and you missed it.
I know.
Cedric.
Would have been worse if it was the home guy team.
Yeah, but it was like, it was one goal when he went, yeah. And then when he came back, there were two nil down.
Xhaka.
They missed the goal.
Martinelli. Assessing the options ahead, looking for Yarmolenko.
Nice.
And at the moment, Arsenal cruising their way to an away win, not being pushed or stretched by West Ham. Xhaka has played it left back and has been covering that position every time Tavares has gone forward today. They look to get through here with the player Saka, who takes a tumble. It's a free kick is in West Ham's favour.
You haven't got the free kick, mate. Miss Rangers. Maybe we'll stay on fans with like that.
Still would have been willing to take the kick, but the team striding over to see how Bukayo Saka is.
That to himself,
didn't he? He just fell over.
Maybe he just gets tripped. Actually, after all of that, Mike Dean left him on the ground and let Paul carry out. Saka is now up on his feet. Easier one. And so far, wide by Rice. Fornals just got away from Xhaka for a moment, but Gabriel gets it away to safety. Zuma winning his battle with Emilio Ketia, just in that sheer strength. Here's Bowen. Now Rice.
Why would you put so much food inside me?
Fornals. So far, Sojic looking to help it on.
It's cleared again, and they're standing really firm here, Arsenal. It's a good test.
You just sense West Ham trying to crack it up now. The fans are urging them to do that. Perhaps that finish.
Well, Smith Rowe will come on when the chance is granted to Arsenal. Here's Mikel Antonio. And it is.
Fuck off! Is it not obvious when six or seven Arsenal players put their hand in here? Oh, it was a corner. It was. Oh, was it? What?
They are more strict wise these days in these kind of situations. They know when to
I wouldn't wear that shirt out in public school. Especially if there's West Ham fans around.
Them for so many years.
He's had a lot of booing.
They shouldn't wear a Boeing one out in public either. The guy fucking died twice.
Martinelli.
Not much time left, is there?
And Neddy.
The West Ham to score.
Cedric. So leaving that one to his goalkeeper. Zuma. Nothing that Antonio could put on there. Do hold out after a run of three defeats. It will be three wins on the trot for Arsenal. This side hitting forward at just the right time.
Yeah, great response to those defeats, thank you, Joe. Also,
what's
I can see Spurs
statistic between these two over the last couple of games.
I don't know what my stand, but I think it was tempted to rugby tackle
to get the ball back then. But, it is a West Ham free kick. That is why.
Loads of different
troubles as well.
Footballers these days.
It's frustrating for Antonio and for Bowen who couldn't get there.
Very good toy. These teams certainly not been at the best. Arsenal haven't either, really. In a strange short contest in many ways.
Well, the league form for West Ham is as the interest in the Europa League has taken hold. Two West Ham fans are already heading out. Clearly can't see a path to revival, but that might change. Gabriel got there ahead of Antonio as Fornells was looking to locate him.
Will there be any injury time still?
It's a foul by
Yeah, I guess so.
Pablo Fornells.
The team in the absence of Thomas Partey, when he is on his way back ahead of schedule.
I mean, old Mike Dean must want West Ham to equalise. Isn't
it?
Being a Tottenham
player. Unnecessary, so close to the end of the game, but it's
Oh my!
And this is where a mountain gets made.
Yeah. It hasn't been an aggressive contest by any means. And Nketiah just trying to delay the
attacking and the free kick. You just got to watch it when you come together with opponents that your hands don't go on the face. Just walk away though, you two were up and
was Tom Weston to do that? He's trying to turn us.
Arsenal going to delay things even further by making a change, a very slow lot with Martin Odegaard.
He'd be adding some time on, won't he?
Very laboured exit to be replaced by Lokonga. A bit more height, maybe for.
I don't even know why the fucking line went off, to be honest.
These disruptions are suiting the visitors more than they're suiting West Ham. Sharply on Mohamed Elneny. It was very, really late in the season that Elneny has started proving his worth again to Arsenal. There you go, last chance salute. Well, Zuma's up there, Rice is in there, Antonio hurls it in. It's defended.
Oh, nice!
Tavares comes clear with it, he's got Eddie Nketiah up to his right.
Come on, pass the ball, you moron!
The middle as well by Emil Smith Rowe, the substitute.
Come on, Lemuel!
But Smith Rowe goes on.
Come on!
And it's
What on earth? All the guard would have buried that. Why did he get taken off, honestly?
Yeah. Well, initially, I think when the ball came into Arsenal's box, it was got the clear in heaven. They have had a few of these situations. Arsenal, they could easily have got a third. Zuma.
Okay, I'm just hold on.
From Alice. So far with the cross, Zuma aimed to get there. Cleared as far as
Pavlova. I don't know what I'll do.
Yarmolenko.
Woo!
Here's Rice with the clock running down. West Ham looking for a level. Fredrickson gets it in, it's an easy clearing header for Mohamed Elneny. And Nketiah holds it up really well. Holds onto it well, looks for the free kick, gets the free kick. Mikel Arteta putting it hard on the touchline. Yeah, and managed to tick down the clock really well, much to the frustration of the home team. But looks like the Gunners have done enough here for the precious 3 points.
Oh, come on,
credit must go to that defence. You have got Holding coming into it to replace Ben White. I think he's an excellent guy next to Gabriel. He scored the goal. A couple of key blocks in the first half, especially. He's got his head to some crosses in the box last 5 minutes as well. So he's my man of the match. Which you might necessarily have expected to be involved in, Ben White being fit.
Should be it.
Just blind
on
the throw in as well. So just looking to keep it now.
this end of the field. Advantage Arsenal in the chase for a Champions League place next season.
Sizzle a bit. That's ice.
Well,
Arsenal
have been very
good this
season.
Bye. Say bye.